The Memphis players making their way through the tunnel earlier, and the home fans are already fired up to get this game started. Welcome everyone to 2K Sports presentation of the NBA this Saturday afternoon. And tonight, we'll see the Memphis Grizzlies as they go up against the Denver Nuggets. This is Brian Anderson with Clark Kellogg and Grant Hill. And giving us the rundown from the sidelines, reporter Allie LaForce. Allie, it's all yours.
Well, guys, the Grizzlies are an elite team, but also one of the league's youngest. John Morant said, quote, "We're just getting started. Everybody's ultimate goal is to win a championship. We've just got to make sure we're laying brick by brick each day to get better. And at the end, we'll build an empire." Brian?
No shortage of ambition, Allie. Thanks for that. Already it's February. Let's see how things look out west. You take a look at the Nuggets. This season has been an absolute dream for them. They're currently at number one as the postseason approaches. And, of course, the Grizzlies, six games behind.
Right now for the Grizzlies, I recall them having a lot of naysayers at the start of the season. But now, they may not have any. This team is ready for a deep playoff run.
They do have the pieces in place for a title run, but the competition in the playoffs will be stiff.
And so let's take a look at the starters for the Denver Nuggets. Caldwell Pope and Porter Jr., they're the two and the three. Gordon is the four with the Joker in the middle. And it's Murray in at the point. And for Memphis, Moran and Bain in the backcourt together. Brooks and Jackson, the defensive forward pair. And it's Tillman in at the five, roaming the paint. And with the All-Star break in the rearview mirror, Grant, what's the focus for teams now?
Well, right now, BA, teams really are starting to think about the playoffs. For the teams that are in good position, it's about what your rotation looking like going forward. And, of course, can you afford to rest your guys?
On the wing, Caldwell Pope, guarded by Bain. Caldwell Pope's shot is off. And here's Bain. Pass to Moran. With the teardrop, and he lays it in.
Able to get that teardrop anytime he wants. Morant has all the shots in his bag.
Morant against Murray. And it's off the back of the rim. No good. And about a minute gone in the first quarter. And stolen by Jokic. Pass to Caldwell Pope. Back to Jokic. Outside Murray. Six on the shot clock. And here's Porter outside. The Grizzlies pull it in. They're coming off that loss against Philadelphia.
They hit a couple big shots, but overall, there was a lack of consistency. Just not their night at the offensive end.
And you know what? If you're not going to outwork your opposition, then you typically are going to get outplayed.
And you can tell how much these fans here in Memphis love their Grizzlies.
Yeah, I mean, B.A., ever since they moved here in 2001, these fans have been so loyal. And the players are also enjoy playing here. Memphis is a fun-loving city with great barbecue and a lot of character.
And he drops the first. Drops them both. Almost 2 minutes into the first here. Offensively, it's been a struggle for him.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
Murray against Moran. Six to shoot. And here's Porter outside. Fires in the triple.
And Porter Jr. feels like he can drain just about any shot, including these corner three balls.
Porter against Brooks. Over Porter. And it's Brooks missing. The Nuggets have gone 1-4 to begin this one. Pass to Murray. Outside Porter. Back to Murray. Jokic with a screen on Moran. Murray for three. And another three for Denver.
immensely confident in his game. Murray doesn't think twice about pulling the trigger from deep, nor should he.
Morant against Jokic. Oh, there's Morant with the slam.
I tell you, a little extra pressure on D when you're up against a point guard who can elevate.
It doesn't make it easy, does it?
And you know, guys, showing how dynamic a weapon he is for this offense, they feed off of that energy and ability to make plays. It gets them going.
Aaron Gordon with one of the best scoring years of his career last year based on percentages. Still a very productive forward in this league.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Off on the first. Man, the leadership Aaron Gordon brings is tremendous, Clark.
Yeah, it sure is, B. I mean, he's been around for a little bit, so he's got some seasoning. He's competed in the slam dunk contest. A lot of hype surrounded him as a younger player, and right now he's a veteran that's poised and mature and does a really good job of mentoring his younger teammates.
And Aaron Gordon, Grant, growing up in the heart of Silicon Valley, San Jose.
Yeah, Aaron, using that to his advantage, involved with some apps. Now, we've seen a lot of players getting into the tech world. Great to see guys like Gordon branching out into business.
And a quick check, the top field goal percentage big men over the last month. Number five is Aaron Gordon.
The challenge for bigs is not only to create high percentage looks, but to also finish consistently. This group, they do just that.
Yes, sir. I mean, shoot, these guys too. Make the most of every one of their easy opportunities. Missing layups is simply not part of their routine.
That free throw good from Gordon.
And, you know, I like that Gordon is a versatile guy who can play both forward spots. He's a terrific athlete who continues to improve.
Aldama's checked in for Jackson. And he makes the first, but misses the second. Memphis trailing here. Outside Bane. Pass to Morant. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a three-point play. And the Nuggets making a change here. Brown's checked in.
Second personal foul. Second team foul. At the line for Memphis, John Morant. At the line for one.
The free throw drops for Morant. First quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. Morant against Murray. Out to the wing. Here's Jokic. Goes to the reverse layup and drops it in.
Boy, slick pass by Murray. He makes such an effort to create for his teammates.
Morant against Murray. Morant, no good. Denver has gone 2 for 3 from outside the arc. Gordon finds Murray. Back to Gordon. To the paint. And there's the call on Dylan Brooks. That's his first foul of the game.
And that puts them just one foul from the bonus.
Yep, they'll be trying to draw that next foul quickly so they can start getting those easy chances at the strike.
Now here's Murray. His scoring ability is impressive, averaging 20 a game. Pass to Jokic. Puts it up. The shot, no good. Now the Grizzlies take it the other way. Victory eluded them last time in Denver when they faced the Nuggets.
And in their last game against this club, turnovers really were a problem for them.
Yeah, sloppy play sabotage. I mean, they'll have to be much more focused this time around.
And it's the Nuggets with the ball. The Grizzlies making their last shot. Murray. And it's Tillman with a rebound. Memphis leading. Now Brooks. In his last outing, he had 11 points. Outside Morant. Nikola Jokic grabs the miss. The Nuggets have gone 3 of 8 so far. Pass to Murray. Here's Jokic, pounded by Morant. Puts it up from 12. The shot's good. Jokic has gotten his second bucket of the game.
Watch out now. When this guy gets into a rhythm, it is something to behold.
Timeout call. Memphis. Substitution here for Memphis. Clark is checked in for Tillman. Conchar comes in for Brooks. Kennard, he's checked in for Bain. And it's Jones in for Morant. And a new group getting ready for the Nuggets. Bryant, he's checked in for Jokic. Green comes in for Gordon. Jackson, he's checked in for Caldwell Pope. And it's Smith in for Jamal Murray. Here's Jones. Checking his stats, he's scoring around 9.5 points per game. Clark with a screen on Smith. Jones, the pass to Clark. Oh, Clark with the slam!
Not the tallest center in the league. He more than makes up for it with those crazy hops.
Smith outside to the middle. And it's hammered home by Green.
That's how you pass the pumpkin. I mean, Smith really keeps his head on the swivel to get that ball over to his open teammates.
Here's the pick. Here's Jones. Good on the bucket.
Defensively, they've got to get more bodies in the paint. That's 3 straight field goals from below the free throw line.
Kennard against Jackson. The floater, and he sinks the layup.
There's a touch of artistry to the floater. Takes feel as much as skill.
Outside Jones. Clark with a screen on Smith. Jones, the pass to Clark. It's good.
His playmaking is something to watch. Threading that pass right in there.
The Nuggets have gone 6 of 11 so far. Jackson outside. Here's Brown. So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting. We see a ton of teams shooting more and more threes nowadays. Here are the best in that department. The Nuggets, number 1.
Having the shooters they have, the best 3-point shooting team in the league, it opens up the whole court by stretching the defense out.
Both free throws good for Brown. The Grizzlies have gotten 7 of their first 12 shots to go. Pass to Conchar. 107 left in the opening quarter. Now Clark. And the layup falls. Clark's got 6 points.
Their defense just falls apart once the ball goes inside.
I tell you, we're taking a look at some real deficiencies defensively. I mean, they've given up 5 straight good looks in the paint.
The Grizzlies have got 8 of 13 attempts to go. Pass to Jones. Kennard outside. Knocks down the triple. And it's a 5-point Memphis lead.
Pick works well there, but the defense left a lot to be desired.
Yeah, that's not the defense you need. You got to be tougher defensively.
Now here's Jackson, taking a look at his numbers, averaging about 11 a game. Good D by Clark.
That's their plan to get him an opportunity to finish in tight. That's a miss they can live with.
Here's Jones.
he was going to get it off in time. Oh, wow.
I agree. I mean, and to have the composure to lock in and get off a shot he feels confident about, that's good work.
And so it's the Memphis Grizzlies closing out this quarter with a 7-point lead. And it's mostly due to their superb shooting. They've wasted very few possessions. We'll be right back after this word. Second quarter action is where we are. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Grizzlies.
Getting downhill has really been impressive to me. Not settling from the outside. They're going right to the rack.
Another area they've excelled in is the points in the paint. They've been able to gouge the interior defense so far in this one.
So many incredible players, Clark. What elite talent really takes your breath away? Is it passing or shooting, handles, or maybe those high-flying dunkers?
Yeah, for me, I think it's seeing the game, and that goes back to passing. Being able to see a player so ahead, that really excites me because not many players can do that. Scoring, you got a bunch of guys that can do that. Athleticism is actually 13 to a dozen in today's NBA. So I like the vision and passing as the skill that most excites me.
On the court for Denver, Porter Jr. and Gordon at the 3 and the 4. Murray and Caldwell Pope are the backcourt pairing. And it's Jokic in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Murray, no good. Memphis leading. Brooks, the pass to Morant. Right side Bain. Jackson, the screen. And he can't extend the lead to double digits. Murray against Morant. Second quarter, and we're just over a minute in. All right, let's take a look at some numbers for Dylan Brooks.
And he's a little less of a go-to guy for their offense now, at least compared to earlier on in the season. You can see his usage percentage is slumping over the last five games. Hopefully, he can be more involved tonight.
Now here's Morant. High arcing shot, and that's 2 points on the layup. And now an 11-point Memphis lead.
It's been a dominant night for him, staying productive throughout.
And that was the mobile one drive. Low resistance to the finish line.
You're toasting the defense and getting in close. They'll take possessions like that one all day.
Murray passes to Jokic. Outside Murray. Shot clock at 6. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot 2. That's on Brandon Clark.
You know, right there in that instance, you could see where Murray was able to take advantage of his size in that situation.
Shooting 2.
And the first one at the line is good. So much NBA talent like Jamal Murray out of Canada, specifically the province of Ontario.
Yeah, very true. And I think that's because guys like Murray, born in the late 90s, they grew up with the NBA in Toronto. And Jamal and others have been inspired by the Raptors.
The Grizzlies making a switch here. Tillman's checked in. And Murray drops them both.
To get where you want to go as a team, you need big game players. There's no way around it. And historically, Murray tends to play his best on the biggest stage.
Now here's Jackson. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change.
And just totally relentless, only increasing the intensity level.
Yeah, I love the fact he doesn't play the score. He just keeps coming, attack mode. He doesn't know how to step off the gas pedal.
Here's Murray. He hits the back iron and sinks it. Murray's got 4 points now in the quarter.
In the mid-range, Murray can really make it happen now. He's just that versatile a scorer.
And it's Morant missing.
Usually, guys, he's going to knock that one down from there. Proficient at operating in that medium range area.
And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into the second. Murray finds Jokic. Now Porter. Outside Murray. Here's Jokic. Misses off the right iron. The Grizzlies have gone 3 of 5 since the beginning of the second. Jackson with a screen on Murray. Here's Moran. It's hauled in by Nikola Jokic. Jokic has got 4 rebounds now. Pass to Murray. Fires the three. He buries it from three. Murray's got 10 points.
Murray's shooting, probably the strongest part of his game. Absolutely exceptional. Whenever the ball is coming off his fingers like that, my assumption is it's good.
Morant missing again. Denver's gone 3 of 4 from distance in this game. Porter the pass to Murray. And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played, here's Jokic. The shot off that time. Ooh, excellent D there from Jackson. Murray against Morant. Oh, there's Morant with the slam.
Plays with so much confidence. When Morant gets in the zone, he stays aggressive.
And the Nuggets call time here.
The son of an NBA player, Jaren Jackson Jr. I actually played a bit with his dad, Jaren Sr., in Orlando back in the early 2000s, which means I'm old.
Williams has checked in for Memphis. And a switch here also for Denver. Najee's checked in. Grizzlies on D. Outside Murray. Pass to Najee. Fires from deep. Yes, and it's Murray picking up the assist. Najee's got his first 3 points of the game. And the Jacksons, just the latest father-son NBA duo. Lots of great ones there, Fred.
So true, B.A. The Curry family might be the best ever. The Berries, including our own colleague Brent. The Thompsons with Clay in the league currently. Just some incredible NBA families to admire.
The Nuggets trail. Here's Porter. And the layup is good. Porter's gotten his second bucket.
Well, you know, on the inside, Porter is a very skilled player. He understands that you've got to be multi-dimensional, a lot of versatility to your game to be effective inside.
Now, here's Williams. He's averaging about 6 points per game. Shoots from the block, and he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
So close on the finish. I mean, it could have been a three-point opportunity.
Full throttle, pedal to the metal, attacking basketball. I like that.
Free throw drops for Williams. And the Grizzlies with some changes. Aldama's checked in for Tillman. Kennard comes in for Desmond Bane. And it's Jones in for Ja Morant. And a new group getting ready for the Nuggets. Green's checked in for Gordon. Brown comes in for Michael Porter. Jackson, he's checked in for Caldwell Pope. And it's Smith in for Murray. And Williams drops them both. The Nuggets have gotten 4 of 8 shots to drop in the second. Smith outside. Oh, and Jackson with the block.
The attention to detail on defense. Jackson reads shooters well and knows when to go for blocks.
Pass to Aldama from downtown. Can't get it to go. Missed his first one. Denver's gone 2 for 2 from the arc here in the second. Smith passes to Jackson. 4-3. Can't hit that one. And the Grizzlies going the other way now. Here's Kennard. Soft touch off the glass. Kennard's got 5 now.
good heads-up basketball. Season opening and capitalizes.
Smith with it. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. And again, Denver no good. And here's Kennard. Outside Jones. Pass to Aldama. Beyond the arc. It's hauled in by the Nuggets. This game coming on the heels of their win versus the Cavaliers.
They were so consistent from the three-point range in that one. And that's a nice weapon to have as a visiting team.
Yeah, you know, the defense had no answer for him. To do that kind of damage on the road, impressive.
Clock at four. For three, Smith. The Grizzlies pull it in. Jackson's got rebound number seven tonight. Here's Williams. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
Well, that was clearly a foul.
Yeah, he took a shot there, earned those free throws.
At the line for two.
That free throw, no good. The Grizzlies making a switch here. Clark's checked in. And Denver with a change here, too. Bryant, he's checked in for Najee. Good on the second one. 1:25 left to play in the first half of basketball. They need something good to happen here.
Yeah, they've gone way too long without a score.
It ran a career resurgence for Reggie Jackson.
Yeah, B.A., after dealing with injuries, even at one point considering walking away from the game, he's found renewed success, and he's shown he's got plenty left in the tank.
Shooting two.
First one falls.
They've been flawless at the line this quarter. They need to stay aggressive and keep drawing fouls. That'll help them chip away at the lead.
And so Jackson nails both of them.
Productive trip to the line. He doesn't like to leave points on the table.
Jones against Smith. Clark with a screen on Smith. Jones, the pass to Clark. Oh, Clark with the slam.
He's just an aggressive finisher there inside.
Hey, when you got bounce like that, you feel like you can take on anybody.
Fellas, that's exactly why they look to get him the ball around the rim. I mean, it's either a dunk or free throws every time.
Jackson gets the bucket.
The jumper is so consistent for Jackson. He's got a great touch on his shot and good accuracy as well.
Let's it fly. Jones misses. Denver's got 4 of 7 threes to go so far in this game. Now Smith. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. Out of bounds. It'll be Memphis's ball. Conchar, he's checked in for Williams. John. 20 seconds left in the second quarter. Jones against Smith. Outside Jones. With 2 seconds left. No good. And so it's the Memphis Grizzlies closing out this quarter with a 7-point lead. Their defensive efforts have paid off, effectively shutting down the opposing offense. We'll be right back.
Hello and welcome, everybody. It was a big first half for Ja Morant, and we've come to expect this.
I love his aggressiveness, getting buckets on buckets. He's putting his stamp on this game.
And credit his teammates for consistently putting the ball in his hands.
Now let's take a moment and see what games still lie ahead. It'll be the Magic out at Amway Center against the Pacers. Tip-off is 7 p.m. Eastern Time.
This feels like a toss-up between have-nots.
Yeah, both teams have faced some big challenges thus far. And that is going to do it for us. Let's get back to some second-half action with Brian Anderson and company.
Well, for those just tuning in, thanks for being with us. So this game's still to play. Oh, a fantastic game from Ja Morant in this one.
Through the first two quarters, he's been on fire. Explosive offensive performance.
And you know what? I'll be interested to see just how much he's got left in the tank. That first half had to take a lot out of him.
And we played through the first half. Plenty of basketball left in this one. The Nuggets trail. Bane and Brooks out on the wing. Xavier Tillman is out there with Jackson. And it's Morant in at the one. That's the five to begin the second half for Taylor Jenkins. Murray passes to Jokic. And here's Gordon. Shot clock at five. That three's off the mark.
And he probably thought he was going to bury that one.
Outside Morant. Pass to Tillman. Fades and shoots. And that one off the back of the rim and in.
And Morant is a natural leader. Someone who wants to get his guys involved when they're open.
Outside Porter takes a three. The Grizzlies pull it in. Jackson's got rebound number 8 here already in the game. Here's Tillman. Nikola Jokic grabs the miss. Jokic has got his 5th rebound in this one. Pass to Caldwell Pope. Back to Jokic. Murray for three. The shot no good. Now Memphis takes it the other way. They held a 12-point lead earlier. Here's Payne. No good. A bit long that time.
Well, that's a rare miss for him inside. He may have just rushed it a bit. Maybe lost concentration too.
Jokic with a screen on Payne. Murray passes to Jokic. Here's Porter. Outside Murray. Pass to Jokic. Shoots over Jackson. And again, Denver no good.
Boy, they need to pick it up here now. I mean, they're 0-4 coming out of the break.
Payne, the pass to Morant. Over Murray. Offensive rebound. Jackson for three. That one no good.
And I'm sure this isn't how they drew it up at the half. Only 1-for-5 here in the third quarter.
On the wing, Caldwell Pope. Here's Jokic. And good work on the boards as they picked up the second chance points. Jokic has got his 3rd basket on the night right there. The Grizzlies have gotten just 1-of-5 shots to drop since halftime. Second half of play here with just under 2.5.
Oh, man.
Oh. Bad intentions.
I mean, just an agile move by Morant down low, working around the contact and getting it to go.
And that replay courtesy of the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Now a timeout called by Denver.
And in 2022, more history made by Nikola Jokic, becoming the first player to amass 2,000 points, 1,000 rebounds, and 500 assists in a single season.
Let's take this time to see the teams who were picking the most pockets over the past month. Memphis, number 1.
They've really gotten after it at the defensive end, and that's been generating turnovers.
From deep, Jokic. And it's Bane with the rebound. And Nikola Jokic breaking barriers at the center position, Greg.
Oh, so true, B.A. That 2,000-1,500 season, it never been done before. The Joker's ability to be a facilitator at the 5 almost a point center. We've never really seen that before. Now that's how you use the screen right there.
And it leads to a thunderous finish. That was nice.
And, you know, not enough help from the defense there to compensate. He gets a clean look, and that's exactly how you draw it up.
Third quarter action, and just under 3.5 minutes have passed. Outside Bane. Down low, Tillman. And he banks in the layup. Tillman's got 4 points now in the quarter.
That's been typical of their performance today. They're sharing the ball and creating good shots.
Really a prime example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
Jokic, good.
Boy, good vision that time from Michael Porter Jr. Saw the wide open teammate and then got the pass to him right on time.
Moran against Murray. The baseline J. And there are the Grizzlies with another bucket. And the Nuggets shooting only 36% so far in this game. Pass to Jokic. Outside Murray. The three. And it's Tillman with a rebound. Tillman's got 5 rebounds tonight. Ooh, poked away. A moment to hear from Allie LaForce.
Well, guys, with the yearly roster moves, it might be hard for the casual fan to keep track. But Commissioner Silver said it's a necessary side effect. He said, quote, we tried to tie performance to pay in a closer way, and I think that's what you see with shorter contracts. Brian, more player movement has been the result.
Yeah, good point, Allie. Thanks.
And this kind of sick slam is just one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game right now, B.A.
You know, there's an edge the way they play and a confidence they're not afraid to show.
Boy, and I used to love going up and jamming it down like that, guys.
Shot is good by Gordon.
Boy, I like the confidence here. Gordon is excellent at realizing when he has room to shoot, even before he has the ball. That's what we call seeing a play ahead.
And it's Ja Morant with the foul. That's his first foul of the game.
And just a great job of getting there first and absorbing the contact.
No question about it. No flop there. That was a direct shot to the chest.
And some changes here for the Grizzlies. Clark has checked in for Tillman. Williams comes in for Desmond Bane. And it's Jones in for Ja Morant. And a switch here also for Denver. Naji, he's checked in for Gordon. Offensive rebound, Jokic. And with that one, the deficit trimmed to single digits. Jokic has got 10.
And credit his teammates for feeding him all quarter.
Porter against Brooks. Clark with a screen on Porter. Brooks with it. Then Jokic picks him up defensively. Here's Clark. Ooh, he's locked in. Dreams his 5th shot in his many attempts.
And that's a backbreaker for the defense. I mean, offensive boards like that run momentum against you.
Well, you know, that's the way it's going to be for them today, fellas. Can't sustain any momentum.
The 3 is up. And the Nuggets hit again from deep.
And this is someone that can really hurt you from long range. He did that to a degree in the first half, and he's doing it now.
Brooks, the pass to Jackson. And the dunk by Jackson.
Terrific accuracy on that pass. That's how you lead your teammate.
Denver's got 6 out of 15 threes so far in this game. Pass to Caldwell Pope. 14 feet away. The Grizzlies pull it in. 13 points was their biggest lead of the game. On the wing, Jones. Defended by Murray. Clark with a screen on Murray. Here's Jones. The kick out to Williams. 3-pointer. Gets the 3 to fall. 6 points for him.
You know, pretty much anybody can hit that shot when they're that wide open. I mean, terrible defense.
Time called here. The Nuggets decide to talk it over.
Protecting the rim has to be their top objective right now.
Yeah, you know, just look at the numbers, guys. I mean, they are being taken to the woodshed in the paint.
And the Grizzlies with some changes. Aldama comes in for Jaren Jackson Jr. And it's Kennard in for Brooks. And the Nuggets will go for a different look here. Bryant, he's checked in for Nikola Jokic. Brown comes in for Porter Jr. Jackson, he's checked in for Caldwell Pope. And it's Smith in for Murray. Smith against Jones. And then Bryant with the dunk.
And what an aggressive move to the rim. He's really trying to fire up his teammates right now.
Boy, it's not hard to feel inspired after a teammate makes that kind of finish.
You know, when you're looking to close the gap, you need guys who will take it upon themselves to step up, take the initiative, and make something happen.
Jones misses. The Nuggets shooting around 41% in the third quarter. It's a four-second differential between the shot clock and game clock. To the middle. Here's Bryant. The shot misses. Good D by Clark. Pass to Jones. Now here's Williams. And again, it's the Grizzlies from deep. And so it's Memphis in a good situation, up by 13 points to close the quarter. They hold a real solid lead right now. Love their approach tonight. We'll be right back with you shortly. While we have a chance, let's go to our State Farm assist of the game.
You can count on him to deliver a few assists like this one each and every night.
It sure is. I mean, he's a maestro. Great vision, terrific IQ, everything you want in a point guard.
There have been two very different performances from these teams today as we get going in quarter number four. On the court for the Nuggets, Murray and Caldwell Pope are the backcourt pairing. Aaron Gordon is out there with Thomas Bryant. And it's Brown in at the three. And the basket by Bane.
This defense just can't stay connected to shooters.
Denver has got 6 out of 15 threes so far in this game. Pass to Bryant. Now Murray. Pounded by Moran. Out to Gordon. 5 to shoot. Here's Caldwell Pope. And right away, they match it with a three-pointer of their own.
Very effective at spacing the floor. Kentavious Caldwell Pope has gone from an average outside shooter to a dangerous one.
Moran against Murray. Pass to Bane. It's wide right. Hits off the rim. Denver's got 7 of their 16 three-point attempts to go in. Gordon with a screen on Bane. Brown passes to Gordon. Here's Caldwell Pope. Outside, Brown. The Nuggets need to get one up. Here's Gordon. And the shot clock expires. 24-second violation. And the Grizzlies with some changes. Tillman's checked in for Clark. Jaren Jackson comes in for Aldama. And it's Conchar in for Kennard. Jokic is checked in for Denver. Michael Porter comes in for Brown. Outside Morant. The floater. Good D by Murray. Jokic against Morant. Here's Murray. Banked it in off the glass.
You know, when Murray finishes like this, guys, it shows you how aggressive his mindset is in attacking the defense.
Here's Morant. And he hits it from 9 feet. Morant's got 23.
An elite score, demonstrating once again how fast he can fill it up.
Right side, Porter. Gordon outside. Pass to Jokic. And again, it's Denver converting.
The defense had him confused early on, but he's responded in the second half with some assertive play.
Here's Morant. Caldwell Pope pulls it in. The Nuggets have gone 3 of 4 in the fourth and looking confident on offense. Here's Jokic. And a miss there with a chance to cut the lead to single digits. Memphis has gotten 5 of their 9 attempts from deep to go. Bane, the pass to Morant. There's the triple. Pure from three-point range. He's got 26.
Morant doesn't need the three-point shot to be effective. There's so much more to his game, but when it's dropping, he's lethal.
Jokic finds Porter. Outside Murray. Pass to Jokic. Just five on the clock. Fires the three. Caldwell Pope's shot is off.
I'll tell you what, they've rebounded the ball tremendously well.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
Tillman with a screen. Here's Conchar. Rejected by Jokic.
Need more of this from Jokic. When he's active on defense, he's a capable shot blocker.
Jokic is doubled. Memphis foul. John Carter. Brooks, he's checked in for Memphis.
First team foul. Coming up to the floor for the Grizzlies, Dylan Brooks.
On the wing, Caldwell Pope. Jokic with a screen on Bane. Clock at six. Inside. Jokic in the post. He's against Tillman. And the basket by Jokic. Jokic has got 10 points here in the second half. Memphis has gone 2 of 2 from outside so far in the fourth. Here's Morant. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws. It's going to be on Jamal Murray.
What determination from Morant in the paint, getting his shot off despite being fouled.
And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the Grizzlies.
They've been all about high percentage looks in this game, working the ball inside and doing whatever it takes to get it to go.
And another thing they've been exceptional at is their passing. On-target ball movement has gotten them a lot of assists tonight.
And he makes a first. Grant, you look at the playoffs last year. I mean, a lot of big-name stars struggled to deliver. Is that every year, or you think that was an anomaly?
BA, I think it was a bit of an anomaly. I mean, I think what's happened in the league in the last few years with the bubble and then the restart last season, there's been a lot of basketball played, and I think it's impacted a lot of players. So I think moving forward, we'll get back to a level of normalcy with the rest and recovery of the offseason, and big-name stars will continue to excel and thrive in the years to come.
Jokic with a screen on Bane. Caldwell Pope. And he sinks that one, hitting the back of the rim on the way in. Caldwell Pope's got 5 points now in the quarter. Murray against Morant. Floats one. And the layup is up and in. And the Grizzlies lead by 13.
In the paint, Morant stays nimble. And that allows him to make any needed adjustment to his shot.
Gordon against Jackson. Here's Caldwell Pope. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up.
Yeah, you got to be careful how you defend Caldwell Pope because he's got great speed and he knows how to use it to draw contact.
The Grizzlies making a switch here. Williams is checked in. One's off.
Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, his defensive quickness sets him apart.
And the second free throw is good. Now here's Morant. The shot's good. Morant's got 16 in the second half.
Deep into the game, you rely on players like him to keep delivering.
Pass to Jokic. And they double up Jokic. And the foul on Jaren Jackson. That's his third foul so far.
13 foul.
And Denver has possession. They trail by 14.
When you're in tight quarters, that can be an awkward pass to make.
He's still feeling it. And another basket for Memphis.
Yeah, the quickness of Morant makes him tough to cover. He's able to pull up on a moment's notice.
Murray up top. Nice jump shot from the top of the key. Murray's got 4 points this quarter.
Strong performance from him, but he may need to do even more if they're going to win this game.
Jackson with a screen on Murray. Here's Morant. And there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
Come on, this kid is electric. Morant draws a lot of fouls with the way he plays.
The free throw drops for Morant. Them both. 1:43 left to play in the fourth quarter. Here's Jokic. Outside Porter. And it's Jokic missing. Memphis has gotten 6 of 10 three-pointers to drop.
Coming out here tonight and making a statement. Really good work all around for the Grizzlies.
It's impressive how the reserve players stepped up and delivered in this one.
They didn't just help out. They made a big impact and really secured the win for their team.
And this victory will put them at 36 wins on the year.
And that's an important win. You never like to lose two in a row to a team, especially if you only see them three times.
Most definitely. I mean, going down 2-0 would have made their third and final meeting of the season really difficult to win. But now they'll go into it with confidence and really liking their chance.
And even the opposing fans can't deny this was a sensational game for Ja Morant.
Well, the defense just couldn't figure him out, and he continued to put it to him.
At the line for Memphis, Ja Morant. At the line for two.
The free throw drops for Morant. And some changes here for the Grizzlies. Mark has checked in for Jackson. And it's Conchar in for Brooks. And Morant drops them both. 52 seconds left in the final quarter. Williams against Jackson. Bryant, a screen on Williams. Jackson, the pass to Bryant. Morant with it. Takes it inside. Clark, no good. And here are the Nuggets now. It's a 16-point game. Pass to Smith. Well-timed pass, and it goes straight to the bucket for the layup.
It's nice they found their rhythm here, but the clock is just not their friend.
Now they're playing with urgency, huh? They could have done it much earlier before the game was out of reach.
Outside Morant. And so it's the Grizzlies taking care of business in this one. Even early on in this game, they appeared happy to be playing at home.
And it makes a huge difference. Once they started to get into a groove, you never really felt like they wouldn't come out on top.
And that about wraps it up. For Allie LaForce, Clark Kellogg, and Grant Hill, this is Brian Anderson thanking you for watching the NBA presented by 2K Sports. Now it's time for the New Balance Player of the Game, Ja Morant.